It's going to be held in Toronto at the Columbus Center, which is the Italian community center here in Toronto. It's called Songs from the Screen, and I'm going to be performing famous film and theater pieces from, movies and stuff like that, and some from my album. And I'm going to be joined with a small orchestra, so I'm really, really excited.
Wow, I love that. I wish I could be there. So, and what's the second one?
The second one is a little bit further away. It's going to be my Christmas concert, also held at the Columbus Center. And yeah, it's going to be called The Voice of Christmas. So again, I'm going to be doing some popular Christmas songs and incorporate a little bit of some other stuff from my album.
Earlier, we were speaking of the possibility that you might be putting together a Christmas album.
Yes, it's still in the early works. Still trying to select all my music. Yeah, it's something on my to-do list and no plans for when it is officially going to be releasing, but yep, I'm working on it.
So, I mean, it's something that may either appear, come up this year or maybe even next year.
Possibly.
You haven't really decided then yet.
I would love to do it, but that's something as an unsigned artist, it's all about finances and, I also produce my own shows and do a lot independently, so it is something that I would love to do, but being unsigned, I can only do so much.
So, are you interested in remaining as a as an independent artist, or are you open to the possibility of speaking with a label?
I'm definitely open to the possibility of speaking with a label. Yeah, I think that would be really, really neat. It has its ups and downs too, just like being an unsigned artist. I mean, the beauty of being an unsigned artist is that you're in control of everything. You're putting on your own shows and you select all your music. You decide what you're gonna wear and stuff like that. But then at the same time, that is also the downfall because no one is helping you with those things or, guiding you in your career. So, I mean, I'd certainly be open to, wanting to talk with a label as well.
Right. Now, if a label, for example, would be interested in speaking with you, where how would they contact you?
I would assume maybe either give me a shout through either a phone call or an email. I just actually updated my website so they can email me through that forum. And yeah, all my contact information is posted through my website.
So not just, labels or anyone else, fans, everybody else, if they wanted to read more about you, learn more about your music, listen to more about your music, you would have everything in your website.
Everything is on my website. Yeah, it's www.alessandrapaonessa.com. And my bio is there. Actually, snippets from my album. My whole album is posted there. Upcoming shows and events, news, what I've been up to, including my contact. It's all there.
Okay, fantastic. Now, let's talk about the second song that I want to share with everybody. It's called Ai Giochi Addio.
Adio Giochi Addio is the love scene from Romeo and Juliet by Nino Rota. It's an absolutely stunning, stunning piece. Probably one of my favorite Italian songs off my album. A lot of fun to sing. And actually, the backtrack was given to me by an arranger from Lebanon named Teddy Nasser. Yeah, so yeah, it was a lot of fun to record. And again, I mean, this whole the way the album came together was just really magical.
Here once again is Alessandra Paonessa with Ai Giochi Addio.
Giochi oddio per sempre sì,
That's a beautiful song, Alessandra. It reminds me of a film, but I'm not 100% sure if that's where it comes from, because obviously it's in a different setting and in a different language. But it reminds me of that song, Love Story. It's an old film, you know, but it's a very beautiful beautiful song. I really, really enjoyed it. Yeah, feel free to jump in.
Yeah, I mean, this one was, like I said, this is the love theme from Romeo and Juliet. And I'm sure a lot of composers, you know, there's a lot of arrangements out there done by, different composers. But they might all stem from, you know, this one song.
Yeah, is this a relatively new song in terms of, you know, putting it together, writing it? Or is this like one of the older arias?
I mean, it's not as old as, you know, say something from Puccini, but I know that it, you know, it's probably written about at least 10 years ago or so. Yeah, I'm actually not sure how recent it is.
I don't either. Okay, well, new or old, it makes no difference. It's a very beautiful song, you know. Let's talk back about this holiday music that you are thinking about writing. That's all then depending on the funding, on whether you have a label to support you or not.
Yeah, I think I'm going to do it whether I have a label or not. Again, it's something that I would really like to do. And I know that I've gotten a lot of requests from my fans to do this. So I've actually started a Patreon page. Patreon is a platform where fans or, you know, people who, you know, really want to see me flourish in my career, they can go view my stuff. And if they feel led, they can leave a little bit of a tip. So I've actually posted on there the ability to, you know, give some if they'd like to give a tip, it'll all go towards putting this album together.
Now, this song, as well as the one that we heard earlier, are on your EP, correct? On your album?
Yep, they're all on my album, Remembering Heaven.
That's the name of, I was going to ask you that. That's the name of the title of the album, Remembering Heaven, right?
Yes, yeah.
And how many songs do you have in that album?
I believe there is 12.
Oh, okay. So it's a full album then.
It's a full album.
And this is available on iTunes?
Yep, available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, through my website and CD Baby.
And what are some of the other songs that that we could listen to on that album?
Listeners might recognize The Dark Waltz and Nella Fantasia. A lot of them actually are originals that were written by the composer Christopher Broom, who I mentioned earlier. So this album really features his work. So a lot of them are actually original compositions and recorded with full orchestra. Yeah, that orchestra is the Air-Edel Studio Orchestra and was recorded in the UK.
Wow. And the nice thing too is that you have everything available, information about it, and the links and everything else right to your website. So if people just go straight to your website, they can just pretty much read and learn everything.
Yep, everything is there. And what's neat is if you buy it through my website, I'll actually give you a signed copy.
Oh, wow. Okay, I'm placing my order. So that would be alessandrapaonessa.com. And that's spelled A-L-E-S-S-A-N-D-R-A. And then Paonessa, P-A-O-N-E-S-S-A.com.
That's correct.
Fabulous. All right. Alessandra, I really appreciate you taking the time to spend with us. It's been a joy speaking with you. And I know you're pretty busy, and I really appreciate this opportunity.
Thank you so much for having me. I had a lot of fun. And glad I could be here with you.
Well, it's a pleasure meeting you.
You too.
You take care then, and please stay in touch. If you have anything else that you want to talk about, let's let me know. And if there's any way that we can be of service to help promote you and your music, we'd be more than happy.
Thank you so much. That is amazing.
All right, Alessandra, you take good care.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
This concludes our interview with Alessandra Paonessa, classical crossover soprano from Toronto, Canada. I hope that you enjoyed not just our wonderful conversation about her work and her upcoming albums, but also that beautiful, rich, and powerful voice of hers. This supremely talented unsigned artist is needing our support to help her complete the albums that she is currently working on, including the holiday album. If you are interested in making a small contribution, visit her Facebook page at Alessandra Paonessa Music, where you will see more information about how to link to her Patreon page to make the donations. Feel free as well to follow us here on Spreaker Radio and visit us often to listen to more great interviews with the world's best indie and unsigned artist on Artists in the Spotlight. This is your host, Pat Stone. Until next time, take care, be happy, be safe, and stay healthy.